After completing her prison sentence, V.K. Sasikala, a close aide of late Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha, returned to Tamil Nadu on Monday to a grand reception. She was sentenced to a four-year jail term in a 66.6 crore disproportionate assets case and was lodged in a prison in Bengaluru. After she left the city's outskirts, she was accompanied by her nephew and Amma Makkal Munnetra Kazhagam General Secretary T.T.V. Dinakaran in a convoy of around 200 vehicles as her supporters raised slogans hailing her. She also offered floral tributes to a portrait of J. Jayalalitha. Her return to Tamil Nadu is being keenly watched as the state's assembly elections is scheduled to be held soon. Here are three ways she could affect the election. Forming a formidable third front. In this scenario, Chinnamma, as Sasikala is known to her cadre, is able to capitalize on her relationship with the former chief minister and form an alliance with smaller political parties and sweep the elections. This could potentially be a dream scenario for the leader. Her party will form the next government and the ADMK will be forced to reconcile with the AMMK. This would lead to the two parties merging after the assembly election. But this could be tough to do as traditionally the third front concept has not worked well in the state. The last leader who managed to do this was DMDK's Captain Vijayakanth in the 2011 assembly election when the party managed to win 29 seats. In 2016, a string of smaller political parties and the left parties formed the People's Welfare Front, but they did not do too well and the front was disbanded. Second, merge with the ADMK and gain control. In this scenario, Sasikala's party merges with the AIADMK and she becomes the party's new chief. Now, she has to match former Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha's leadership and work to fight the anti-incumbency in the state. But she has one thing going for her. She will be going to polls using the memorable two-leaf symbol. The problem here is that the current AIADMK dispensation has no reason to join with the AMMK right now. Vote cutter for the AIADMK. The AMMK could potentially hurt the ADMK by splitting votes. If the party divides the traditional ADMK vote bank, even in a few constituencies, it could make all the difference. In 2019, the AMMK managed to garner vote share in rural pockets mostly. The party's vote share in the Lok Sabha election was 5.27% and about 7% in the assembly by-polls. T.T.V. Dinakaran has not been able to replicate his 2017 victory when he won the R.K. Nagar constituency after J. Jayalalitha's death. If the AMMK could build on this victory, they could potentially become the kingmaker, especially if the election is a close one.